Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. Well, I was working on this shopping app and here I have this personal center, and here we have this address. So once you click on this, it takes you to new page and it asks you if you have want to allow the app to use the map while the user uses it, and you can click on this and we see things like this. Of course, you can zoom in and you can go to an individual page or screen like that, and you can enlarge it here, tap wherever you want, but you can ignore this message for now. So you can come back and it'll select or keep the original, the one you picked just now. Anyway, so I wanted to show you how to use Google Map on Flutter app, so let's go ahead and do it. Okay, so the first thing, we need to come over here, console.cloud.google.com over here, and first we need to register our app. Okay, well, this is my app that I've been working on, but we'll do it from the scratch. Okay, well, so first thing first, we need to register an app. So once you come over here, there might not be anything over here, but whatever it is, you can click this and create a new project. Okay, so that's what we'll do. So I clicked on it, and here I'll write Google Map Test App, like that. Okay, all right, and then I'll create on this click button. All right, and you might not have all these pages, but you can ignore them, whatever it is. And here you click once again. Now this is the app that I've created. So we'll select this one first. Okay, all right. So once we are here, you can close this, you can open it. Okay, now next, what we'll do, we'll go ahead and click on this library over here. Okay, all right. So now here, in general, if you want to use your this Google Map for your Android app or iOS app or web app, in general, you'll select this three. Well, first we'll go ahead and select this Maps SDK for iOS. All right, and then we need to enable it. So this Map SDK for iOS is selected for our this certain project. Do remember, we do have many projects here. In your case, you might not have any of this, but we are working with this one. So this certain SDK for iOS only enabled for this one, so we can include over here from here for Android. Okay, so all you need to do, come over here and click on this. Okay, well, it might take a bit of time, but you always have to make sure that these APIs are enabled. If you want to work with the web app, or definitely you'll select this other one, I think Maps JavaScript, this one. Okay, well, once that is done, you're good to go. Well, we'll not enable this one for our web app. Next, we'll come over here and select credentials, or you can select it directly from here. Okay, and once again, it will take us to a new page, and over here we'll set up our credentials. That means we'll create APIs. Okay, all right. So right now you see it's all empty. So we'll create API keys, actually, not really API, sorry. We'll create API keys. Well, Google already has those API. Once we have the keys, we'd be able to use them in our app. It could be web app or mobile app, doesn't matter. It could be React Native app, Flutter app, iOS app, or Android app. It doesn't really matter. The steps are same, okay? All right, so over here we'll go ahead and click on this, and we'll now, a lot of time you can just come over here and close it and you're good to go, but that's not good. So because you should restrict your API. All right, now restricting your API keys has to do with this certain type of apps there you are going to do. So first we'll restrict our API keys for iOS app. All right, now here it would want you to use the bundle name of your iOS app. Now, every iOS app, the bundle ID is unique, okay? So we have to provide a unique bundle ID. And in this way, this API key and your bundle ID are connected. That means they just belong to you. Other people won't be able to use it, okay? Now, of course, we need to create an app first to get a bundle ID, right? So that's what we'll do. So over here, I'm at Android Studio. So I'll click over here and create a new Flutter project at Android Studio over here. And here I'll create a new Flutter app. So I'll come over here. So Flutter project, and here say my app like that. And whatever it is, I will keep it there. But here you can put your domain name if you want, or any kind of unique name you think that's unique. Now we'll go over here and create it. Now, once we create an app, then we'll be able to get the bundle ID for our Flutter app. Flutter app works both for iOS and Android, but for iOS part, it has bundle ID, and for Android part, it has package name. So anyway, we'll come over here and I'll select this folder. Now I'll drag and drop it to my Xcode. Now before that, I have to go ahead and open it. So let me open my Xcode. This is my Xcode over here. So now I'll drag and drop this one to my Xcode. Okay, and now it'll open up over here. And I'll click on runner, and here I get my bundle identifier. So I'll copy this one and put it over here. And with this, we're pretty much done for iOS part. Okay, and we can do more. We can restrict the APIs that we want to use for our iOS app. So here, we can just do maps, so like this one for our iOS app, maps SDK, then we'll select it and save it. Now it'll generate an API keys for us. It might take a bit of time, and it'll show up over here. So now as you see, it's in green. That means there are no problems, and we have one API for our iOS app, and this is the API key. So what I will do, I'll go ahead and copy this one, okay? All right. Or you can copy it anytime. Now, we'll come over here, this over here, and we'll follow the steps for our iOS app. Now, for iOS app, there are certain steps that we need to do. So we need to go ahead and find our appdelegate.swift file. And it's easy to find. It will come over here, iOS, inside runner, and here as you see. Okay, so here pretty much you need to mention the libraries that you want to use, and also at the same time here would use our Google Maps. So we need to mention it over here, that this Google Maps library and our key. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll go ahead and copy this one, import Google Maps, and I'll put it right below Flutter app, this library. And then it also says that you need to have this section, GMS services, and we have to use our key. So what I'll do, I'll put it right there. Now here, this section key, we have to use the key that we just got over here. So we'll copy this one and we'll put it over here. Okay, so now this key for Google Map APIs and only belongs to this app with this identifier for this key, okay? So that's the one of the steps and settings for iOS, and we have another step that we need to follow. Okay, so over here you need to put your own key, not my key, the one I have. Anyway, so there is another setting that we need to do for our iOS app. Now that setting, we need to find our info plist file and we need to give the access. All right, okay, so that's what we'll do. It's easy to find once again, so we'll come over here and the thing we just copied from here, this section, we'll just put there, and it's a pop-up for user that we are going to you need to enable this map for your app like that, okay, and yes, no, things like that, okay. All right, so with this we are pretty much done for iOS part. Actually, right now we can go ahead and run our iOS app, so, and we'll see that how it works. So over here we have this main file, main.dart. Well, what I'll do, I'll just completely delete all of it, and I have the piece of code ready directly over here, so I'll copy this one and put it there. Okay, all right, I think let's see. Okay, well, that's one thing, but before we can use Google Map, we need to go ahead and install the package in our pubspec file. Okay, all right, so I'll install it over here. I'll do Google Maps, Google Maps Flutter. Okay, all right, so I'll do get pub, so it'll get the packages for us. You can get any version you want, just mention your version name, and I think it's done already. So we'll come over here now, and the packages are already imported over here. Okay, all we did that we got a Google Map controller and we got a instance of latitude and longitude. That's all coming from this package. Okay, and we are passing it a default one, but in your actual app, maybe you want to get it from user and then you pass it. Okay, and we have this widget Google Maps, so we are calling it and passing this function on map created, okay, as well as some other extra values. But this part is pretty simple though, so only thing we want to do, we want to go ahead and run and see whether it works or not. Okay, well, it might take a bit of time. Let's see, well, it's trying to launch it, so we need to wait. Okay, well, now there could be a version problem over here. So now let's go ahead and change the version, because a lot of the iOS older version doesn't support this thing. So what I'll do, Flutter clean over here. Flutter clean. If you want to work with Google Map and things like that, make sure that you remove the old compiled file and start from the scratch. Otherwise, a lot of the compiled file or binaries, they're still in the this app cache, so you need to remove that. Okay, all right, now let's go ahead and run it. Hopefully the error should be gone. Okay, well, hopefully the map showed up. It's a bit slow over here. Of course, this is not what we saw earlier over here. Now, this part is, of course, a bit advanced, just not a simple code like this. Anyway, so if you want to get this app, just the source code, just check out the link below. Okay, all right. Anyway, so now what we'll do, we'll go ahead and do it for Android app, and we'll see the settings. Now, for Android app, you need to also get your API key, and you will get it the exact same way over here. So we'll create another credentials, and we'll click over here, and we'll restrict the key this time again. We need to wait a bit. Okay, so this time we'll use Android apps and here add item. Well, now here, instead of bundler ID, we need to put our package name. Now, your app's package name, you can always find over here in the manifest file. So we need to come over here And inside app, we have source file, and inside that we have main file. Now here, this is our package name. So that's what we'll copy and put over here. Now, this is ShakeOne certificate fingerprint. We need that one for verification, but we need to generate this one. Well, to generate this one, you need to come to your app at the terminal, apps root folder, or at the root, and then you need to copy this lines. But now this lines actually you can also find from here, okay, based on where you are on Android, Linux, or Mac, okay, exact same one. So in my case, we are doing on Linux, so or Mac, so I'll copy this one. And so this one and this one, they're the same actually. So you can just copy from here, and we'll run the command over here and hit enter. And sorry, I do have some Chinese, you don't need to worry about that. So this is the key that we are looking for, and we'll copy this one over here and put it there. Okay, so this is ShakeOne key, and we'll just put it there, and we'll do done. And here we can also once again restrict the API. This time it's for Android. Now we'll save it. But do remember that you can use the same key for Android and iOS, but you might encounter some errors, okay? So that's the first settings for, I mean, that's how we generated the key for our Android version. Now all we need to do, we need to come over here and put it somewhere in the app. So now once again, we need to go to this Android manifest file, which is already opened over here. Okay, now over here, what we'll do, we'll just copy this one. So this metadata, and we need to put it right below this, I think this application, let's see. Yeah, right below this application tag, and before your activated tag, okay? Now we need to copy the code for our Android version. So I'll just click on this and copy it. And I'll put it, okay, all right, put it there. And let's see what else. We might also need to mention this one, this user permission, okay. So but I think that should goes let's see, before application tag. So we'll put it there, before application tag. Okay, so these are the two settings for Android version. And oh, there's another one, the build Gradle file. Here you need to mention your minimum SDK version, so we'll go ahead and find it. So this is the build Gradle file we are talking about inside app folder. Now here we'll find our minimum SDK version in the configuration section, so we mentioned it 20. So, and after that, you should go ahead and run on your Android simulator, and there shouldn't be any problem, okay? Well, now, if you do have problem, now it depends on a lot of things, what kind of SDK version you're using for Android and your machine and a lot of things. So for Android, the total setting is not that difficult, but a lot of time it depends on your simulator. Like for me in this simulator, I can't really run it because I'm on Mac, okay? So it depends what kind of system you're using, and you might need to change your target version, minimum SDK version, and compiled version, okay? So with iOS it's pretty simple, but with Android it a lot depends on your simulator version, compiled version, and minimum SDK and target version, things like that. Anyway, so these are the basic settings that you need to take care of for Android and iOS. Anyway, hopefully if you learned something, if you did, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button.